Guys, we are here with another tutorial video, and today we are learning how to add custom font in our Shopify store. And as you can see, after applying the custom font, you'll be able to change the fonts like I did it here. So if you want to learn, watch the complete video, subscribe the channel, comment on the video, hit the bell icon so you can get the notification whenever I create new videos. Let's jump into the tutorial. Okay, let's go to the back end of our store. I have already opened it, so let's go back to the dashboard. Here's the back end of our store. Click on online store. Here we have our theme active, debut theme. Before doing any code changes, I suggest you guys to make a copy of your theme so you can easily revert back if you mess up anything in the code. So let's duplicate our theme. Okay, here is the copy of debut, which we know that it's the original code. We can also rename it from here, so to make sure that we have a backup of our theme ready. Now what I'm gonna do, I'll go to edit code, and here we have assets. Click on assets and add a new font, whatever you like. Now let's search in some fonts, free fonts. Okay, here we have our font. Okay, which one you like? I like this one, it's different. Let's try this one. Okay, now click on download. Give it a second to download. Guess I'll need to click on it again. Oh yeah, download. Here we have the zip folder. Now let's go to unzip it. Download, here's our folder. Extract all. Okay, now we have a font here. Now issue with this font file is that it's TTF, and Shopify do not accept the TTF format. We will have to convert it to WOFF or WOFF2 format, which is acceptable in Shopify. Now let's convert it using an online converter. Online font converters, I'm gonna Google it. And there's a website where we can convert our fonts. Oh, there's another one, which is onlineconverter.net. Okay, weird, that one is also not working. Let's search some other online font converters, and let's try this one. Okay, let's convert our TTF file to ODF, and there's the folder where we have font and the TTF file, and I'm gonna convert it to WOFF web open font. Okay, here's the web open font start. Okay, our font is ready. Now let's download it. Our font is downloaded. Now we will upload it to our Shopify asset. Add an asset, choose file. Oops, sorry, I uploaded the DTF version. Let's upload the WOFF version, which we converted. And here's the WOFF version. Open, upload asset. And here we have our WOFF version. Now let's apply it to our theme. Find the CSS file. Here's our CSS file, main CSS file where all the CSS exists, theme.css. And when you'll open this file, you will see a lot of code. I think it got stuck. Let's refresh it. Okay, here's our CSS file. Now let's go to the bottom of the file. And add some comments. My custom CSS. Make sure to add something like this to identify yourself for the future use that this was the custom CSS which you added. So it's easier for you to remember that you added some custom code. Okay, now we need to add the code which to pull our font file which we just added. Okay, so I have the code ready already. So this is the code which I am gonna copy and paste. Here's the code. Name of font, let's name it Amsterdam. And our font file is, as you can see here, we make sure to do not make any typos because otherwise it won't work. So I'm just gonna copy and paste our font file here. Okay, let's do the WOFF1, not the TTF1. Just WOFF, copy and paste it here. We are not using WOFF2 version, we are just using WOFF version. So I just added the change the format to WOFF. Now, okay, we just need run. Cool. It's safe. Okay, we have defined in our Shopify store which font file we'll be using and what is the name of the font family. Now we need to tell Shopify that which element we need to add in the custom CSS for, the custom font for. Now, for example, if we need to apply the custom font to this heading, we'll go to inspect element, inspect. And this is the class where we can add our custom font, as you can see. So I'm just gonna copy this class and add it here. Okay, h1 dot. Now change the font family to Amsterdam. So I'm just gonna copy it and paste it here. Now hit save and see how it looks. Okay, hit refresh. Oops, something is not right. Let's see what we did wrong. Okay, so it looks like the font family is already defined here and we'll have to override it by adding an important tag. Let's add in important and hit save again and hit refresh. Still not working. Okay guys, so once again our font is not working, is not loading properly due to the reason that it's unable to decode. As you can see, the font which we added in here, which we added in our asset, is unable to decode by the browser. So I paused the video for a while and downloaded a different font by the name of Bubble Shine. And now let's try change of font and see if it works. Make sure the file name should be same as what you uploaded in your assets. The bubble shine dot. So this is the font which I am adding now. This is the font. I downloaded it from thefont.com. Maybe the website which we used before didn't give us the correct format. So I used a different website this time. And here I have updated the URL and the format. Everything's good. Now let's update our font family name here. It's safe. Let's go back to our website, hit refresh. and boom, our font is working fine now. So again, if you get the same error of the decode error, so it might be something related to the font file, make sure to download the correct file format and convert it to WOFF2 format and use the code here. I'll also add the code in the video description so you guys can easily find the code. And you can also target other elements in your website. So for example, if I need to change this text here with the updated font, I'll just go to inspect element and okay, let's see what's the class. So it's h3. Now let's add in and I'm gonna copy the font family here. Make sure to add an important because they have already been defined. The font family, we need to override it with the help of important. It's safe. And now all of the H3s should be updated with the new font which we just uploaded. Okay, it's class and the element is H2. So .h3, I missed the dot here, it's safe and it refresh. There we go, our font family is updated now. Awesome. So in a similar fashion, we can inspect any of the element and add in the custom font which we have uploaded. I hope you guys liked the video. We also found out the bug within our video, how to whenever you see the decode error, what you need to do, you just need to change the font file. If you like the video, comment on the video below, like and share. Have a great day.